Have a seat and welcome to another edition of the Court of Public Opinion. This special feature of Junior Court up next. Got a feeling higher than high. This is the real thing. Introducing the Court of Public Opinion Junior Court. The Court of Public Opinion is a part of the Amateur Radio Network. Well, the reason we are warming you up for a very important topic and discussion, and I hope that all of you know by now, vote Barbie. She's going to be the one to best represent the issues. And for those of you who are concerned about some of the things that your kids are watching, either whether it's on TV, well, on the internet, YouTube kids, you're gonna have to really look into the issues that vote Barbie, because Barbie is going to discuss these issues and in a way that I think is going to be helpful to families and parents. It's a therapeutic tool We have used in play therapy, so we're going to implement this as part of that project. And I hope that any of you want to support us, please go to Patreon, become a patron. And we're consolidating all this stuff, and we're just going to call it censored news. Since it's been censored on the internet, we're just going to call it censored news. And no pun intended, but that's what it is. I've been waiting to make this change. I've been gradually making these changes, and honestly, I have to condense it all into one thing. So we're just going to call it censored news from now on, because the topics that we are discussing are censored. Okay? It doesn't matter what side you're on this issue. We're going to discuss this. This is that issue. Okay, this is Teen Vogue. Okay, now this is an article which, if any of you had screenshotted this or found this on the internet, this is one of those images. I had to censor it. There's no need to go into descriptive anatomy and go this far with it. But, I mean, I know that when you're, you know, 7, 8, 9 years old, 13, you're just starting to know what your body is and reacting to it. Okay, that's called awareness. I mean, to understand your body is to understand it, okay? And you have a body, so you have to treat it as such. When Teen Vogue goes this far with it, I guess there's going to be a huge reaction. Already there is, and there should be. I just want to keep the emotions intact, because I know this is going to be an emotional topic. If somebody was abused this way, this is going to be very sensitive. So there are some things here that I think Teen Vogue... when you realize what this means, it brought it out in the forefront, because now I think what they did is, by encouraging this, now they've opened up the floodgates, because parents are now reacting, and this is the mass awakening. Okay, and I'll explain why, because I'm not going to go too far into this. We're going to take a break in a few minutes, because I don't think we can tackle this topic all at once. But I want to state this. My cousin was a 17 model. Her son was a Versace model. I've been around it all my life. I've dated a model. I've been around it all my life. You know, the influence. And I bought the teen magazines, you know what I mean? And then I ended up, by accident, becoming an assistant to CoverGirl Jennifer O'Neill. And if anybody knows the story about her, she talks, you know, she was, my name, I was named after her, you know, in the story, love story of all things. But I ended up being her assistant one day. And been around some of it. I mean, anyone that's been around people influence, you know, you've probably met some people in your life, but that was my background growing up, and I've been influenced into these things too. I bought the books, I bought the magazines. So I know what a teen crush is, and to think about what a teenager is experiencing, like they a crush is one thing, kissing a boy, holding his hand, that's a big deal to anyone at any age. And these kids are just kids, you know, they're playful, they're silly. And now what is happening is, what's blurred us is that culture has been so sexualized. And I'm not saying that you can really argue that people don't have their issues or views. But one of the things we've talked about several times here is you have to draw the line with the kids, because there are things you have to protect them from. And in the 80s, which most of us are very much influenced by the 80s, that's why I even have a show called Miss Deja Vu, because we listen to music from the 80s, the 70s, and it's all light, and that's why we do it. The point to this is that the 80s was a very big period. It was influential. It was Ronald Reagan. It was all these things that we grew up with. And when you see this magazine... Okay, that what that says to a lot of us is, you know, this is what they are raising them to be. And you know what? There's going to come a time you're not going to be able to argue with these kids, okay? They're going to be already set in their ways. A lot of them already are. They won't listen to anybody, okay? They're already very much used to having their way. And parents who, you know, in all honesty, you're looking out for your kids because you want to be protective, and you teach them some things so that they aren't vulnerable to given into peer pressure. Peer pressure is a big one. It's a big one for anyone at any age, okay? There are pressures, okay? But as adults, we're supposed to be able to recognize that, yeah, we're, even for adults, it's a big story, okay? I was taken back by it because I didn't think that we would really be talking about this today, but maybe it's, in all honesty, this is the best thing that could happen because now they're bringing it out in the light, okay? All the issues that some of us have been dealing with, okay, it's debilitating to have social problems because social problems, I think, are a contributor to a lot of the problems that are going on in your home, okay? Culture has a lot to do with what's going on. You send your kids out there. If they're not, the way I was raised, if they weren't wearing the right clothes, they weren't accepted, okay, into the popular crowd. And that's very hard for kids to accept. And the missing children epidemic, I think, is tied to that. Because there are, I think, good, I would say, you know, well-meaning people who leave kids out of parties, functions, and they leave certain people out. And that, well-meaning people is well-meaning people, but you shouldn't do it, okay? It's just one of those things. It's just out of courtesy and hospitality. I've been around the hospitality business. I've been around this business long enough. I've been in the background. I mean, for me to be doing radio, it's just not what I wanted to do. But as an assistant, I had to learn how to do their job, and here I am. So we started the Court of Public Opinion. And somebody can always fill my shoes. It was created with the idea that somebody could step into this role, any of these roles, because I did not create it for myself. This was not motivated in that respect. I knew the time was coming, though, that we had to create a platform where we could literally put, you know, a well-known celebrity in front of the mic here at the Court of Public Opinion. As an assistant, though, I'm doing the job that they need to be doing themselves. And I'm sure right now that somebody's going to fill these shoes because I have to go to my other job. And that's coming very soon. But I'm making these changes because you're going to see censored news on our rotation. You're going to see the Court of Public Opinion. You're going to see the Moonlight Lounge. And I just wanted to leave this out for some of you because I'm not going to always be here doing this job. I'm going to make sure that this job is ready for somebody to, you know, step into this role. But we knew this day is coming. It's here now. Today was literally the day. Today's the day that I think of discussing it. Okay, so those people who have lived this sexual lifestyle, maybe they've lived a homosexual lifestyle or been, you know, living this way all their life. Okay, here's the problem. Even somebody that's had, you know, a questionable lifestyle, when it comes to kids, it'll take some people back because I think what happens to some of us, it brings us back to when we were kids, okay? What it was like when you were raised with standards. And the thing is, if we don't have those standards as a building block, what happens, these kids you can't rescue them down the road. They won't be filling the void as parents. What's going to end up happening, I don't know what a child's life will be like 20, 30 years from now if we can't help and protect the kids now. Because we want to raise these kids right now with the awareness that we have. And hopefully we give them a well-rounded view. They are going to have options. At this point, it is liberating to not feel ashamed about your body. It is liberating. But what is not healthy is that 30 years from now, when some of them are sick with HIV or disease, I mean, they're going to be living difficult lives. For some of you who have lived with a sexually transmitted disease, could you imagine how debilitating it would be? You're not going to live a long life, a long, healthy life. So we don't want to raise our kids with the intention that their overall health is going to be affected by this. Set aside the culture issues. It's a health issue. And that's why they've always had AIDS awareness and all this stuff going on, because the HIV epidemic hasn't changed. It's affected children, it's affecting adults. I mean, it's obviously an issue. So I find it's very irresponsible for Teen Vogue to advocate for this while on the other side they're advocating for the AIDS research and things like that. To me, it's too much. I can see here where we have a platform, we can weigh these issues out. You can have people that are going to bring in different views. It's for that reason. The point is, we want to build something so that they build a foundation where they can make choices, healthy choices, okay? Choices. When they say pro-choice, I want to see them make healthy choices and looking at the science and looking statistically at what has happened in the course regarding abortion. There are a lot of health issues. Underreported. When they talk about pro-choice issues, they also underreport the other side of it, the health issues. Some women have died. I mean, it's underreported. The facts still remain. This is still a controversy issue. And when you see women who are going down this direction where they want to get behind Linda Sansour and they want to take over the catwalk because the hijab looks good, that's why we introduced Barbie, Judge Barbie, because if you're not aware of this here in Pittsburgh, and I've been saying this and I'm going to keep saying this, there's a Jewish community here, okay? And I actually have family that's Jewish, but there's a Jewish community and a lot of groups that are helping these young Muslim women make hijabs. So where's the support coming for us? You know, it's like we literally ask for it. We don't get any support, but these agencies are funding this. We don't get funded for making Judge Barbie, okay? What I'm saying is, and we're creating a platform for a couple reasons. We're creating a platform called Creative Conservative Girls. We're also creating another clubs, literally just clubs, nothing like no brand. There's no branding here. It's a message to the kids. This is a message to the families to start paying attention. And now I think this is waking people up. And what is going on is that you got Creative Conservative Girls. You also got some issues with kids. Overall, just kids. And what we want to do is with Judge Barbie, since they're funding the Muslim hijabi girl, Barbie, we need you guys to get behind us, because here's the thing. We're the ones that are getting, we got to have an answer. We have to have an argument, or we have to have a rebuttal, okay? Because obviously they're insulated. They're well-funded, but we don't get funded, and I don't know why. Either conservatives are starting to get behind each other and fund each other because they're well-funded, and I don't know why people aren't helping. I really don't get that. No one can argue. If you want to take back the fashion industry, the art industry, the music industry, we're ahead of the curve. We've been trying to do this. I see a lot of conservatives, well-meaning, but you're not. You got to get back into this. You got to get back into the culture, and that's what the Court of Public Opinion is trying to do with Vote Barbie campaign, because we have this campaign. This campaign's so important. It's a way to communicate to kids. And I can't think of a better time to do this, okay? Because we know elections are going to be coming up in a couple years. I mean, we have another election coming up this November for judge. And that's why I think this campaign is important for a couple reasons. But when we discuss issues about predators and we discuss all these issues, there should, right now, this blog post and many blog posts like this, we should be filling up conference rooms at hotels at the Hilton. We should be filling up the Trump Towers. And actually, if any of us have an opportunity to talk to the president, we should be filling up the conference rooms for meetings and sessions like this. And what's going to end up happening, I believe it'll probably happen. Anyone that's ever worked in the hotel restaurant industry, that you see a lot of things, okay? A lot of people see a lot of things, but what is the message? You see these things, but what's the message? What is the message we're not sending? Because I thought we were very clear. We're not going to sit around and let everybody just kind of poo-poo this idea. It's out there, okay? And you could go down the street. You can see what's going on. You could see the clothes, and no different. We were all edgy. I was just thinking to myself, I mean, I liked Madonna's music to a degree till she started really, I mean, going a whole different direction with it. There was a lot of us that grew up liking this stuff. But you draw the line because for a lot of reasons, because our values are different for obvious reasons. We don't value, I grew up much like many people grew up like Madonna. Cheerleading was popular. That was the thing. I don't have kids, so I can't speak to this, but I can tell you the issue on awareness, it hasn't changed. It hasn't changed. So I know that somebody's going to be sitting in this chair very soon, okay? And they're going to be sitting behind the mic. I'm just warming you up for what's ahead. Because we created this platform for a couple reasons. First of all, for somebody to get behind the mic and fill this and sit in this chair, it's well established that there's somebody that's gonna have to fill these shoes, you know what I mean? I'm just the assistant, and I've been an assistant, and that's why I did all what I did, okay? Learning how to be a radio host is another thing, okay? I've done a pretty good job. I took the voice coaching classes, but I have to tell you, this job is just not for me, okay? I hope somebody really takes over the role as radio host. I don't mind doing radio at all, but I don't want to do it as a career, okay? And I would even ask if anyone wants to participate in voting for somebody to fill this shoes, I'm all for it, okay? I want somebody to do this because I see the Court of Public Opinion in some of the groups that we're doing in the campaign, Vote Barbie campaign. I see this as a very significant time, and I haven't heard back from Coach Dave. I'm hoping Coach Dave will step in and help us here because there's a lot of things he knows that I don't. There's a lot of things a lot of you know that I don't know. I would love that, and I want people to be, you guys are in charge here in a lot of ways. This isn't my show, this is your show, so what you make of it, you are the Court of Public Opinion. So whatever we put into this show is going to be up to you, the audience. And if you join up and you sign up and become a patron at Patreon, this is your platform. So get creative. That's why we created some groups called Creative Conservative Girl for kids that like fashion and art. I like that idea because that's the direction I want to go into, because we want to influence kids in the right way. We want to influence them in art. We want to influence them in music. These still things matter, okay? And photography. We want to be influencing them correctly. Even if any of you have messed up in any area of your life, this is not that. You still know the ground rules, okay? And we'll tackle these topics another time. I don't think it's the time to go into it today, but I just want you to be prepared, because when we're warming it up, for now we're warming this up, and I think you're going to start hearing from, we're going to hear from you. I know it, because I know you're going to want to respond. If you want to respond by video, send it to me. I want to take your videos. I respond back with video, respond back with memes, respond back, do get creative, but respond. So we know that the issues we're touching matter to you. I know they matter to you. It's just whether you respond. A lot of people don't respond, unfortunately. A lot of people don't respond and they end up unsubscribing. This is your channel. What you make of the Court of Public Opinion is on you, okay? We just created the platform, okay? You are the audience. You are the judges, okay? I hope you know that, because this is up to you guys. We just set it up so that you would have a place where you can be an independent contractor here, more or less. We can get funded. We can get sponsors behind us too. And you can be a shareholder in the Court of Public Opinion. Well, okay, so with that said, I really want to talk about a lot of other issues, but I'm not going to be able to do that today. I got to get some things done, but I just want to get you all ready, because we are working on the Vote Barbie campaign 2018 right now, and we're going to discuss a lot of the topics. I hope for some of you, if you have any concerns what those topics might be, I mean, we're just going to be prepared as best as we can to get the Vote Barbie campaign. And the Creative Conservative Girl, it's a style project I started working on last year during the MAGA rallies, and what we're doing is we're just putting it all together, and we're just calling it Creative Conservative Girl. The Vote Barbie campaign, though, is the Court of Public Opinion. So we have two things going on at once, but basically we're converging it all together, calling it Censored News. And it's going to be a lot easier because we can do a segment called Creative Conservative Girl under the banner of Conservative News. the Court of Public Opinion and some of our other articles and posts. And we're going to also ask some of you, if you're a writer or you're a journalist and you want to help put this together, or you want to kind of put together a newsletter, I'm asking you guys, go ahead, because I can do the memes. We can put this show together. We're going to try to do our best. We've put a lot of hours in here to get the background stuff done. We got the studio ready. So we really just need a host and somebody to take on some of the duties and get sponsors. That's where we're at. So in the meantime, what I'm asking you is to sponsor us, to keep us going until we get a national advertiser or somebody behind us really soon here. So we're leaning on the Court of Public Opinion to keep us afloat till we get advertisers. And so we have a lot of goals, and that's where we've been going. And like I said before, we're changing the whole platform. It's going to be under the banner of Censored News, and you'll see the different segments, and we'll lay it out so some of you won't be confused navigating it. Thank you for listening to a special edition of the Court of Public Opinion Junior Court to bring awareness to issues for families and children in family court. Thank you again for supporting us, and also go to Patreon and become a patron. We need your support.
No more living in shame. Telling all those lies, it's been too long. No more living in chains. No, I don't give a damn what the people say. There's no use holding back desire. We burn our fingers, now let's jump into the flame. Stronger than strong.